I want to see if there's any treasure chests lurking about. This is dead end here. Who the hell? Archem says, oh, Dr. Bandle. Huh. And it says Dr. Bandle with an exclamation mark as his name. Yes? Hi, it's you. Hello, Archem. Thank you for the other day. The Meefa got well, thanks to you. He smiles. The Meefa came to thank me just now. It was jumping cheerfully, so I think the wound had healed. By the way, are you Avon and Mile? And Douglas, too. Avon says, hello, Dr. Bandle. Nice to see you again, says Mile. So you know Dr. Bandle, too? Douglas says, yeah, we met in Boren. Dr. Bandle also helped us, says Avon. Really? You're helping people in various places. Mile asks, did she help you too? Yes. She treated a Meefa who was wounded by an arrow. It wasn't much of a treatment, Dr. Bandle says. I just helped a little. You're so humble, as always, says Douglas. By the way, what are you doing here, Doctor? I'm looking for herbs. This forest is filled with a very clean atmosphere, probably because Meefas live here. I can find many valuable herbs here. Okay, says Avon. But it's dangerous to do this alone. Shall we escort you back to town? Thank you, but I'm fine. I want to stay here a little longer and pick herbs. I know how to protect myself, so don't worry about me. Protect yourself, says Mile. You can call it Art of Shiatsu. Monsters are also living beings and have nerves. I can control most monsters by pressing certain acupuncture points. Douglas says, okay, you're using an art of medicine as a weapon. In a way, says the doctor, so you don't have to worry about me. All right, says Avon, but do be careful. I got many valuable herbs, but I couldn't find that flower. But I won't give up. Huh. Wonder what flower the doctor's looking for. Oh, cool. I knew there's a reason I'm looking around here. Another Reeb leaf. There's a bunch of them now. Eight of them. Okay. Can I get up there? So this whole section is just a dead end with the chest and Dr. Bandle. I wonder what the floating lights are all about. Missed. find if there might be any more treasure chests. I don't want to take her home yet, though. I want her to fight with us. Makes it a little bit easier. Northwest, so her home is most probably up there. We were just walking. East is Golda Cave. I don't know if we want to go there yet. So it probably came from here, I guess? Yeah, east is Golda Cave. Oh, let's go up to her house. One-shotted. She says whoa when she attacks. Just caught that. That's cute. House in forest. Yeah, that's all there is here, just a house in the forest. Stuck there. This is my house. Please wait here. Grandpa, I'm home.
Archem? Were you trying to stop the hunters again? How many times have I told you to stop doing that?
I'm sorry to make you worry, but I can't just do nothing.
You totally inherited your mother's stubbornness. She, too, always wanted to help when people or animals were in trouble.
Old Man Caraba. That sounds familiar.
Well, that's okay, as long as you are safe. Who are these people?
They saved me when I was in trouble. This is Avon, Mile, and Douglas.
Oh, really? Please come inside, everyone. We don't have much to entertain you, but please make yourself at home.
Thank you, says Avon.
Thank you for saving my granddaughter. I can't thank you enough.
It was no problem. We happened to pass by and decided to intervene.
You all look like very skilled people. What brought you into these woods?
Miles says, we were looking for someone, and we thought she might be here, but I guess we were wrong. Avon told him about searching for ML.
I see. We do live in this remote area of the woods. Our connections are cut from the rest of the world. It's understandable that you thought your sister might live here.
Why do you live here? Says Avon.
Because a long time ago, Supreme Priest Asparius of the Bardas Church asked me to protect these woods. Since then, we've been living here quietly.
Sir Asparius asked you to protect the woods?
It was to make sure that no one was hunting the Meefas.
I assume you've seen the Meefas?
Yeah, says Douglas. How did you know?
I can smell Meefa's fragrance on your clothes.
The unique fragrance that they give off affects our mind. It calms us, while at the same time purifying poisons and evil spirits. For that reason, they are sold for a ridiculous price and are extremely valued among aristocrats. That is what led to the excessive hunting. Meefas almost became extinct. Since ancient times, Meefas were said to be the divine animals sent by Durga. The Supreme Priest was very concerned about Meefa hunting and issued a notice to prohibit it.
I didn't know about this, said Avon.
But recently, the residents of New Boren have begun ignoring the ban and hunting Meefas anyway. I don't get why the people are ignoring the rule now. It has been in place for decades. I guess they just want to make money. I don't understand what they are thinking.
You know, Grandpa, the hunters were saying... She told him that Meefa hunting is now encouraged by the Great Oracle of the Church.
Yeah, whose name is Avarice.
What?
I can't believe the Bardas Church is encouraging Meefa hunting.
Douglas says one of the hunters we just met didn't seem to want to hunt the Meefas. Maybe they're being pressured by the Church.
This is a serious situation. If the Bardas Church has approved it, Meefa hunting will come back with a vengeance. Meefas might go extinct this time.
No way, says Archem.
Mile asks, is there any way to stop the hunting?
That would be difficult, says Douglas.
Hunters do not care about the pain they are causing. All they care about is themselves. They are not going to recognize the true value of the Meefas until they are gone.
It's not only about the Meefas. There is a reason why Meefas are said to be the divine animal. Something disastrous might happen if we don't do something.
Miles says, what kind of disaster would occur?
I'm not sure, but I shouldn't say anything if I am uncertain. One thing's for sure, we need to take action right away. We need to knock some sense into the Great Oracle. I will write a letter of protest.
Then we will deliver it, says Avon.
Sounds good, says Mile. We must have been meant to come here and help you.
I am in service of you guys, says Douglas. I will go anywhere you go.
Guys, says Archem.
I am so grateful to you. I'll write the letter right away.
That was quick. Arthur has come back saying, I don't have a pen. Or pencil.
This should do.
Avon was entrusted with Oracle letter.
Where do we deliver it to? Asked Avon.
There is a building owned by the Bardas Church in the west of New Boren.
It's a historical building called the Benequia Monastery. We were just there.
I've been to that monastery.
Yeah, see the beginning of last episode, guys. Avon says, we'll go right away.
Avon, can I come with you?
Huh?
I want to help too.
I usually can't help with anything, but I know I could help you, please.
Mr. Avon, please take her with you if it's not too much trouble. She is very stubborn. She won't give up.
It's no trouble, but...
All right, let's go deliver the letter together.
I'll send her back home and we are done.
Thank you, Avon.
Let's get going right away, says Douglas.
Miles says, the Benequia Monastery is to the west of New Boren.
Yeah, we just were there.
Yay! The Benequia Monastery is west of New Boren. If you could meet with the Great Oracle of the Church, please hand this letter to him.
Well, men aren't supposed to be there. I guess it's a good thing
we have her with us, and she's going to have to deliver the letter, I guess, and not going to let anyone inside the compound.
By the way,
You really look tired. Why don't you take a rest while I make some tea? That's a good idea. Come back anytime you get tired. Well, no, we don't feel like running back here every time. But thanks. Alright. Back we go. We could buy her a better mace. The Great Mace, or whatever it's called. But I don't know if she's gonna stay with our party. She might. I mean, the plan so far is for us to deliver the letter and then for her to go back home. Of course, that might not be what happens. But I don't know if we want to invest that money just for her to leave. I mean, Douglas definitely looks like he's going to stay with us till the end. Split up here. Death to snails and beetles. It doesn't look like a beetle. So I press left and go right. Isn't that weird? Left. My meters are 3 out of 4. Filled up. But these things aren't that tough on their own. I just feel like it's kind of a waste. Antidote. Just two of you? You're doomed. The monastery is in the west side of New Boren, if I remember correctly. A So where is that going then? Wait a second. South of... Oh, that's right. That's the South Guia, which is really west. I guess it goes south and then west. Well, it goes west and then south. Sorry. East is Newborn. Okay. I hate these shell things. Uh-oh. Use some finishing moves on them. I want to see hers. Wind Lullaby. Oh, she can hear all of them. Give calmness something... Are you kidding me? Little lammy pies. And put them all to sleep. That's a cool finishing move. Aven and Mile. Level 12, and Mile got Magic Shield. And Archem, level 10, and got Rarer. It's an improved healing spell. Alright, Magic Shield. An auxiliary spell that increases magic defense to repel enemy spells. Makes sense. What else would be... Magic Shield B, right? Oops. I guess we're turning this way. Oh, hi. Oh. Flamethrow. Sword Wind. He needs healing. South. Let's see if there's any new dialogue with her in the party. And I'm gonna buy her... I don't know if I should. We didn't have two people here before, did we? Oh, we got... Polna says, Meefa's fur is beautiful, but the remaining part of the animal is useless. I can't complain, though. We are getting lots of roses for the animal from the high-ranking priests at church. I don't remember talking to these people. Oh, it's Hunter Rob. The Bardist Church banned hunting Meefas in that forest a long time ago, but the new great oracle at the monastery has lifted the ban on Meefa hunt, yet we know. We don't want to do it personally. But I'm a hunter. I wouldn't want to know what the Bardist Church or a Great Oracle is thinking. I want to know. It doesn't matter if I hunt for wild boars or Meefas. As long as they get an order, I'll do my best to catch them. Catch them? You mean kill them. With my bow and arrow. sells various stuff. That's the way to the monastery. Ah, crap. There's a big monastery to the west. Young innocent girls come from various places in Elfilden to serve Bardas God. Bardas God? But things are getting a little strange lately. The monastery began ordering food from us. They want all kinds of junk food and drinks, things nuns normally refrain from eating. I thought the monastery was growing their own food. I wonder what happened. Let's see if anyone new is upstairs. Probably not. But... Grat says, I don't feel good hunting down Meefas, especially when I catch a family. The crying voice of a small Meefa whose mother I killed is still lingering deep in my ears. Archem says, separations of parents and children is a tragedy for all life forms. Meefas are a family-oriented animal, and you destroy those happy families. You're right. I think I should quit this job. I wasn't born to be a hunter after all. Tony says, it's a peak season, but I couldn't catch anything today. My motto is to make easy money by taking an easy job and then play around while the money lasts. If you have anything to say, say it to the Great Oracle of Bardas Church staying at the monastery. Where there's demand, there's supply. That's the way of the world, right? I have no intention to stop hunting Meefas. Bartender says, animals called Meefa are living in the forest to the north of this town. I hear the Great Oracle is encouraging us to hunt Meefas lately. Meefa's fur sells for a lot of money, but why does the Great Oracle approve of such an act? I might have read that before. It's truly deplorable. How can they catch Meefas against the ban? I don't know what kind of disaster will befall us. Disaster? Says Mayo. A disaster will befall those who antagonize the sweet-smelling animal. It's an old prophecy left in this place. My grandfather's grandfather's grandfather actually learned a painful lesson himself. Meefas give us easy money, so young folks are leaving their steady jobs to become hunters. That itself is already a disaster. Now it's time for me to go and get some job. I'm properly dressed and equipped. I'm full of spirit. I've eaten my meal. I have nothing left behind. Okay, I'll catch a lot again today. Douglas says, hey, don't say you're also going to hunt Meefas. Don't insult me. Killing such an innocent animal is a disgrace to my adventurous qualification. What I mean is catch a lot of monsters along the highway. Oh, I see. Well, I'm sorry I suspected you. Douglas says, I can't take the guild's jobs for a while. I'll leave the monsters to you. I'm ready. You don't have to tell me. You don't have to tell me that. Okay. I envy the children of Borin. They have many friends to play with. I want brothers and sisters myself. Get back here. Oh, who's this? Hey, Mr. Karamis. Oh, hello, Avon. Is your journey smooth sailing so far? How about you? Is your writing smooth sailing so far? Although, Ryan, I do look familiar. He's the author. Karamis chuckles. Do I look like I'm having smooth sailing? Chuckle. Well, as a matter of fact, I just ran away from Geomane. That means it's not smooth sailing, says Mile. The bottom line is, yes, you're right. Anyhow, I began writing my new book, Quick Raven, but the story didn't develop the way I wanted it to. I stopped my pen, and it hasn't been moving since. So, I need your help. Do you have any stories I can write about? Let me see, says Mile. What a writing genius, says Avon. Mile told Karamus about the adventures he had encountered.
Really?
Right. I see. I may be able to write something. I had an inspiration.
Wow, yells Douglas.
You scared me, says Archem. A flame of creativity began burning inside me. Endless water is springing up from the fountain of artistic talent in me.
Didn't he say the exact same lines the last time?
Yes. Oh, it's coming. I must write.
Did we help? Says Avon.
Yes. Thanks for your help. I'm going to write.
All right. How about a plot like this with a subplot like that?
Yeah.
It's the same thing you said before.
If she stays with us for a while, I'm gonna get the mace from him.
The hunters came back from Meefa hunt. I didn't sell them weapons so they could go and kill such an innocent animal.
Meefa hunt was banned by the Bardist Church until recently, but when they lifted the ban, everyone scrambled to the forest to catch them. Meefa's fur is beautiful, but I don't want to wear a fur coat knowing that such lovely animals have been killed for it.
Douglas says I don't care about their fur either, but I do care a great deal for their meat.
Everyone's speechless.
It's just a joke. Don't look at me like that.
Douglas, you live by your instinct like an animal. Sometimes I can't trust you.
How dare you say that?
She dares very much. Oops.
What's wrong, Mayor? Asked Douglas. You seem troubled.
Well, we received an order the other day from the Great Oracle staying at Benequia Monastery. There is something I cannot understand. I don't know what to do.
To begin with, the fact that the Great Oracle encourages Meefa Hunt perplexes me.
It was the Bardist Church that banned Meefa Hunt in the first place.
Well, it's because he's an oracle called Avarice, that's why.
That's all you need to know.
Avarice.
The Meister says, Hi, Douglas. I have a job for you. You want to make money, don't you?
We read this before.
Talk to everybody? I know we talked to her. What is the barrel of water?
We have nothing to say to the barrel of water. It is beneath reproach.
I'm gonna save my money rather than buy that stuff from him.
Okay.
Okay, so next episode, guys, Benequia Monastery, again, for real this time. Thanks so much for watching, see you next time, and always, seek adventure.